This is the very first military burial ground.
Stephen Carney is command historian at Arlington National Cemetery. He lives for American history, especially that of the U.S. military.
And here is where it all began. This is the grave of Private William Christman, who was buried on May 13, 1864. The cemetery began when there was no burial space left in Washington, D.C. There were so many wounded and sick soldiers coming into the hospitals in the D.C. area, it outgrew the capacity for cemeteries.
The time was the mid-1800s, the end of the Civil War, a bloody period of American history when South fought against the North.
It became a cemetery when, by 1864, the national cemeteries that had been established here were simply filled really beyond capacity. But right across the Potomac, you had 1,100 acres of essentially an untouched estate that was suitable for a burial ground, and it was very close to the district to actually be able to get out here.
So this was born out of necessity?
It was definitely born out of necessity. And that necessity began really at the beginning of May of 1864. So our very first military burial here was May 13th, 1864.
Now, I've also read that Arlington was a reconciliation point between North and South in that time.
So from the very beginning, there were Confederate soldiers buried here at the cemetery. But in 1900, the cemetery truly does become a symbol of reconciliation because Congress authorized the creation of a Confederate section. Today we call it Section 16. In the year 1900, a large amount of pedestrian traffic would have entered on the western side of the cemetery and have gone right past the Confederate section. In 1906, Congress authorized the creation of a Confederate memorial at that section. And the memorial itself, it's called the New South. Definitely a powerful symbol here at Arlington National Cemetery.
This is where I think a lot of military leaders chose to be buried with their men?
When a lot of those leaders, a lot of the officers of the Civil War begin passing away, so many of them decide to be buried here with their troops. Section 1 of our cemetery today really overlooks what we refer to as, or what was called at the time, the Field of the Dead. Today it's Section 13, but it became the primary burial ground for a majority of our Civil War dead. You see the same thing then coming into the 20th century. So General Pershing is buried in Section 34. He wanted a simple soldier's marker, and he wanted to be buried at a spot where he could overlook the men that he led, the men who had served him so well during the First World War.
Arlington also is known historically as where Memorial Day began.
The commander of the Grand Army of the Republic, which was the veteran service organization of the Civil War. It was open to all veterans of the U.S. Army, Navy, Marines, and Revenue Cutter Service, which today would be the Coast Guard. And it was their commander-in-chief who issued a general order recognizing May 30th as Decoration Day. So that very first Decoration Day here at Arlington National Cemetery in 1868 was a tremendously popular event. Within a few years, there were over 25,000 individuals coming to decorate and to honor the 16,000 or so Civil War dead that were buried here.
The Tomb of the Unknown Soldier, how did that begin?
There wasn't an original plan to have a Tomb of the Unknown Soldier here at Arlington National Cemetery. Our memorial amphitheater was constructed between 1915 and 1920 because of the popularity of Memorial Day here at the cemetery. There was no plan to add a Tomb of the Unknown Soldier here, but in 1920, on Armistice Day, November 11th, the British and the French both start a Tomb of the Unknown Soldier or Tomb of the Unknown Warrior at Westminster Abbey to honor their World War I dead. So early in 1921, Congress authorizes the United States to also construct a tomb. It was decided Arlington National Cemetery was the most appropriate location. The tomb was an add-on to the original plan for the Memorial Amphitheater.
And now you are marking the 150th year. Another piece of history.
Absolutely. It's been an incredible 150 years. And you know, Arlington isn't just a place to come to honor the dead, but it's also a place for the living as well. And that's one of the important things about the cemetery is the explore piece. I mean, it's something that we think of every day. You know, how can we enrich, how can we enable our 3.5 million or more tourists that come here every day to get out and to explore the history that is Arlington National Cemetery. There is just so much here. There's such a vast history. I really want people to take away an appreciation of just how many individuals served and sacrificed for our nation, not just the veterans, but their families as well.
If you spend any amount of time at Arlington National Cemetery, you can't help but be touched by the traditions that are such an integral part of the fabric of the place.
Tradition at Arlington National Cemetery is synonymous with the Old Guard, the oldest active duty regiment in the Army, tracing its roots back to 1784.
Tradition is one of the most important things that we have to carry on the legacy of the military.
Command Sergeant Major James Bodecker says being a member of the Old Guard gives him a deeper perspective on service to the nation.
You're a combat veteran of both Iraq and Afghanistan. You're now here in the National Cemetery. Does that make it more personal?
Absolutely. I have friends, fellow soldiers that I've served with that now lie to rest here. I still keep in contact with some of the family members. So to be here and watch over them on a daily basis means a lot.
Arlington is the premier national military cemetery, a final resting place for U.S. service members who've served the nation since the Civil War. Today, more than 400,000 veterans and their dependent family members are buried at the cemetery. From sunrise to sunset, 24/7, 365 days a year, roughly 1,500 soldiers of the 3rd Infantry Regiment, the Old Guard, here to pay homage as recognized presenters of honor, respect, and tribute to America's fallen.
Up, louder, hard.
The millions of people that come to Arlington, what do you see in their faces?
Power.
I don't think that they exactly understand the magnitude and the size and the atmosphere that's here. So when they get here, I think it kind of almost overwhelms them at times.
So as we now get ready to commemorate the 150th anniversary of Arlington National Cemetery, where do traditions fit into this?
Every day. Traditions fit into everything we do every day here. From the presidential salute battery, to the caissons, to the funerals, to the firing parties, to Memorial Day. Flags in, flags out. It's everything.
Do you think that once you leave here, your time served here at Arlington will leave a definitive stamp on you?
Absolutely it will. Yes. It's changed the way I've thought about things.